Father, where he belongs, a paraphrase, is the same Jesus that will come back. Go back to Jerusalem and wait for the promise of the Father, for the power for you to do the work of God. The point there is this: after Jesus Christ ascended back to the Father, this is the work of the church, the work of the Holy Spirit is moving and doing. God is continuing doing the work, or Jesus is continually doing the work by the Holy Ghost now. So he says that, and then, follow me, and then, make it shortcut, to the Holy Spirit, and God is giving this to the apostles and the disciples, to the Lord of God. Now, the same commandment of the Lord is now given to every member of the church. So the plan of God from the beginning of the church to the very end of the church, that all nations of the world can hear the gospel, forgiveness of sin in Jesus Christ, and they'll be accepted to the death of Jesus Christ, and there is hope for tomorrow, and that is the word of the church of God. The work of the church of God is not to be comfortable in at least in a church. No. It is not the weekly activities that we're doing and all the programs that we have. No. Thank God for that. I'm not against that. But any church negative, we don't go to the positive, that is doing the root in 7 days a week, which is internal only without looking around in the neighborhood, the church is passive. And the church is inactive. And the church is selfish because the eyes is going around the circle inside the church only in the same people. The plan of God is from Jerusalem, it will go to all the nations of the world. You know, church? If you go to Blackdown Council, we have now 120 nationalities in Australia. You didn't need to go out of the country to go to Vietnam or Cambodia. And God's commandment to all of us as a church, how blessed we are, all of us are blessed. And we have eternal life, we have God. But I tell you, because Christianity is generous, I cannot afford and we cannot afford to enjoy the things that we got. But we love to share this wonderful grace of remission of sin, forgiveness of sins, and acceptance of Jesus Christ to 180 nationalities. If we can reach 5 nationalities and 10 nationalities, we are fulfilling what God has started to do and to teach. Amen. That's the way the church functions. I'll be finishing because this is only part of the introduction. The Holy Spirit is teaching us and teaching me. I know this, but the Holy Spirit is teaching me as I communicated to you. He's the one. So, Church of the Living God is very important that the Holy Spirit now is working to the active, sensitive, responsive individual as God commissioned us to continue to relate the story that the hope of the world is Jesus Christ, and they will be saved and they will be healed and they will have eternal life. And it must be an ongoing work of every individual, each one. Okay, I'll be closing in this area. I've only, out of 4 pages, I've only 1/3 of 1 page, but I'll be closing in a few moments to you. If many churches will involve to what God has prescribed, it saddened me. Listen to this. When I say this, as I feel in my heart, many churches today, the root of the church, and it's not to, you know, to rebuke any one of you, this is the nature of the church. They come to church, and they hear the word of God. They go home, They give their tithes, Bible study. And then, the sad thing about that, it is a maintenance church that does not even touch the icebergs of the people in the valley of decision, in the mouth of hell, according to the book of Isaiah, is enlarged every day. Let's make another reshifting of our focus, which is, Lord, you bless me so much in the church. We have not to focus in the direction of the heart of the Lord, because I tell you in the next study, Jesus is the model in an example. If I'm connected with the Lord Jesus Christ, which I am, you are connected with the Lord Jesus Christ. If the sap is so healthy and so nutritious, I have no question, and God said, I have no question. The nutrition that you are receiving from me, the lifestyle, the passions, and my dreams, and my focus in life, is going to be your dream and pass your life because you are connected with Jesus Christ. So, it's a time for us, Lord, could you help me to see what I can share to the people who are my neighbor? Because never in the history of the church is confined to the four corners every Sunday. It is not. And I thank God. That's why, by God's grace, God has put me to you. Because we're training pastors. You will be seeing pastors now. I want to learn now. David is a candidate to start a ministry in Wagga Wagga. David is being mentored, and he can testify one day. By telephone, I communicate to him the things that needs to be done. And I just talk to him, and every time we talk, this is what I receive. And he is being mentored by long-distance telephone. He is a Portland's instructor of pilots. And so, Johnny, I have now a house. I bought a house. And then, whenever you come with your family, you have a room. I said, yes, I have some contact there. Are you ready? We'll begin a ministry there. I'll follow you up by telephone. Yes, I'm ready. He'll be an extended on the training, pastor primary in Wagga Wagga, touching those pilots and their family in Wagga Wagga. So our church is not isolated. We'll be, it's on the process of looking for a place. You'll be seeing soon. Another, I want to, but what I'm trying to do, we'll be seeing, because I am training even pastors around me that plant with me. There's about 9 pastors who supported me in Christmas in July. I don't know them, but they line up with us because they can see the plan of God. When God is giving you the word, people will respect you. So you cannot respect it based on your word, no. They can see you. They can hear you, and they observe you, and once they see the beauty of the Lord, they submit to you. So the influence there is not the ability of the mind and the control, no. It is by the way you live, the way you talk, the passion, and they know that Jesus is in you. How those people, 9 pastors, Baptist, Anglican, Uniting, Independent Pentecostals, Hillsong, how are those people coming when we invite them? They must respect you. Do they respect me? I'm very short and ugly. God is dead, but Jesus is alive. Can you say amen? Amen. That's the way people respect you. So this morning, as I close now, we pray that we worship our hearts. Lord, what can I do? Continue praying for the word of God, for Christ of the word. Continue to pray for my pastors. One man that is singing, they'll be part of the Seven Hills of Tongali, will be an extension worker who are doing some kind of another pioneering church. And I will supervise these people. And new people are coming. And we have in Riverstone, 3 pastors, 3 of us, we have permanent service every Thursday, Rudel, and then Aris and me. And people are coming to the Riverstone And Sophia, beautiful woman of the Lord, he come to know me there and then attend the service and then communicating to me. I said, if you are free, could you come to our church just nearby, which is here in Scotland, and you are here. A very influential woman that we can connect with the member of the political. He is a very influential woman. When I invited her, okay, he come. Church, this is important. The work of God will continue. It will continue not to a pastor only, but to all of us. Yeah. Member of the men'ship told them, one with a spirit of martyr got saved. I don't tell them I'm a pastor. Am I special? Everyone is special. One man by the name of Edmond, very faithful man, very, very gifted, skilled man. We have the podium there, first container, and Edmond come. They didn't know I was a pastor, but when opportunity comes, open your mouth. It's not the gift of evangelism, it is a matter of the heart. When the heart is pure and loving God, you cannot help it. It will spill out love. I told them, accepted Jesus. That one accepted Jesus. You know what happened? Close. 2 months, just 2 days ago, he died, maybe at the age of 75, member of the men's shed associated with us. And I thank God, before he died, he received eternal life today. So I encourage you, church. We thank God. Lord, what can I do? Ask the Lord with all my gifting. 10 to 15% of the work of 100% in the church. 100% work of the church is being carried by 15% in the church. But I think the church, we're acting. 100% of our church, that's my prayer, will be acting to do the work of God. Don't depend on the pastor. The work of the pastor is specifically to equip you, and the work of the ministry is given to you, not to the pastors and ministers. Our work is to equip you, show you, and when you do the work, Jerusalem turned upside down from Judaism to Christianity, because all the members of the church, from 120 to 3,000 to 5,000, were all busy. They Christianized the whole Jerusalem in a short span of time because everybody continued to do the work of God. And that's my prayer. We'll continue to do the work of God. Not one man, two men. Not only 50%, but 100%. Amen? Amen? And when you do that, you'll see more miracles. There are more miracles. You'll be seeing. It's happening. I want to open up, and I pray for those people who are praying with me, 8-10 people, some are pastor driving so far, that they'll experience the Word of God in real person. Father, I thank you today. Thank you for your love, understanding what we ought to do, what we must do, as we'll be touching those issues, Lord, by next month. Help us to be responsive, obedient, submissive, and humble. And thank you for your faithfulness and for your kindness to all of us. You love this church and I love this church, and they love you and they love us. We'll continue to honor you for being so good. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to render a song to you, and then I give you.